Did Bandai change the rules to swap? Swap is a keyword ability that was introduced in set 4. If we read the card, Bardock the Progenitor, it has a keyword ability with a swap 2 for a Goku's lineage. It reads, swap 2, Goku's lineage, with an energy cost of 2. Play the specific card from your hand, then return this card to your hand. So with this wording, you can play Bardock the Progenitor for 1 mana and then swap it out for Scrambling Assault Goten for no extra cost. With the wording of this card, it would go as follows. Play Bardock for 1 mana. Then you activate the ability of swap, playing Scrambling Assault Goten, and then returning Bardock the Progenitor to hand. But it seems as if Bandai has changed their mind on how swap actually works. If we read the Q&A from the official website, there is a question that says, can you choose not to play a battle card specified by swap? And the answer is yes, you can. If you do so, you still return the battle card that activated swap to the owner's hand. So with this new ruling, you can play Bardock the Progenitor for 1 mana and then activate swap as cost to add back to hand. The effect is worded that you have to play the card first, but the way it's ruled now is that you can just add it back to hand for cost and not play a card. I really don't like the way that now this is ruled, but I guess that's just how things are and we're just going to have to live with it. With this new ruling, it is easy to bait out counterplay cards such as Cold Bloodlust and Crushable. You can activate Bardock the Progenitor on the field to add back the card to hand, which would open up a window for counterplay options because the ability of swap is to play a card from hand. But if you choose not to play a card from hand, and they've activated a Crushable when Bardock is returned back to hand, you can choose not to play a battle card, which would make the effect of Crushable to fizzle. I hope that helps, guys, and I'll see you in the next video.